both with signs and wonders and divers miracles and gifts of the Holy Ghost according to his own will. What's he going to bear us witness of? Well, that we're the people of God. And how are we the people of God? Well, because we have faith. So what I'm saying is, because this is a close of an age, because this is the end, we don't want to look back, as the scripture says, and say, what is the cause that the former days were better than these? Now, because you're not wise to do that. And I'm not wise to do it. Don't we do that in our life? Don't we look back and perceive maybe in our earlier life or in our earlier Christian life, things seemed a little bit better. I seemed like I had more of anointing on me. Things were a little more peaceful. I wasn't quite as much trouble as I am. I wasn't as troubled about things as I am. I wasn't going through as many trials. And I knew certain Christians that used to do that. I do that. So you can do that as an individual. We can do that as a church age. And by and large, that's what I came across when I first was filled with the Holy Ghost and I was in the UPC. Everybody was seeking the manifestation that they knew from the 40s and the 50s and the 60s, the things I never saw. And they were looking for that mighty revival, right? Win souls and all that whole episode. Well, Doubting Thomas, he saw, and he put his hand in the side and all of that, and he believed. And so you know what Jesus said. He said, Thomas, blessed are they who have not seen but still believe. That is profound faith. Lord, I don't have to see anything. Just speak the word, and that's all. That's all I need to hear, the word of God. And it will be so. Well, we talked about that too. The two most profound examples of faith singled out in the Bible was that centurion soldier, and the other one, of course, was the Syrophoenician woman who had such faith, who was so determined to embrace faith that she would not accept rejection from the Lord, so much so that she spoke and demonstrated a faith that Jesus marveled at. It's not meet to take the children's bread, he said, and give it to a dog. It's not right to do that. So the woman was identified as a dog. The Bible says outside the church, outside the believers, for without our dogs and whatever. See, without our dogs, beware of dogs. Because human nature, the way people go after their pursuits in life, to satisfy themselves, to gratify themselves, they go through concerned about themselves. It's like a dog.